Susan Hawk, a truck driver from Wisconsin.
Hi, Dad.
I'm just thinking, I think we're off to a bad start.
Why? Because we're not talking?
Yeah.
Sometimes, though, Richard, you kind of got to do things and talk as you go along, and sometimes things can't be that planned out.
I agree with you. The problem with having no conversation whatsoever, or lots of people talking about different things, is that nobody's working toward a particular goal. Not the silly little stuff about, oh, who's going to sleep where, what are we going to do, but why are we here? And what's the point? And if we don't
set up... Oh, I figured that out before I come here.
For you.
But you haven't?
And I have, for me. But we haven't for us. And for the next 7 ejections, 21 days, we have to function together or we fail.
What do you think we're doing now?
Not functioning together at all.
I'm a redneck, and I don't know corporate world at all. And corporate world ain't going to work out here in the bush.
No, and I'm not talking corporate world. I'm talking creating a team. Just and working together.
We're doing good, but see, so creating a team is actually putting all of our hands together and walking. And
not hands, all of us knowing what we're doing.
The head thing, yeah, but that's action, man. Action, Richard.
If we get fire, it means we're going to have a hot meal in our stomach, which is going to bring up team morale. That first hot meal might be rat soup, which I'm, like, looking forward to very much because there's nothing wrong with the rat. All a rat is a squirrel without a fuzzy tail. Stacy came up to me and it's like, she don't like Rudy. And she's like, oh, we think we're gonna vote for Rudy and vote him off because he's so barking. Well, anybody's too barking, too bossy is Stacy because she doesn't move her ass. The chicks think I'm voting for one person and I'm not.
I remember the weakest link in the crew.
First person voted off the island. Sonya. Tribe has spoken.
Sean sits there for 5 hours and builds a super pole and doesn't catch anything with it. I told him it was a waste of time. Oh no, it's not a waste of time. Well, did you catch any fish? No.
3, 2, 1, eat.
Go, 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 go,
as far as the food holding up, I think we're into day 7. I lost track, but I know it's starting to whittle down. I know we gotta get fish in here though.
I already know who I'd vote for. The person that's least contributing to the group. Out of here.
I have conflicts, personality conflicts every day with people. I deal with them, I work with them, I live with them, I go on. I'm gonna do the same thing here. I'm gonna get rid of the weakest member and vote Stacy out. Stacy's trying to buddy up with everybody because she knows she's the weakest. I can only take so much preaching. I went to church, I put my time in, I believe in God and all that, but the constantly, everything, they always come back on me, Jesus, Jesus. Yeah, Dirk's about driving me wild with that.
It's important to keep winning these games because for one, you win the immunity, you don't have to go through the brain rush of worrying about kicking somebody off your team.
I told Stacy I was gonna vote for Rudy, but I was thinking about voting for her because she was the weakest. I gotta think of the team. That's what I come in here for.
Susan, you've been quiet tonight. What are you thinking right now?
I'm thinking right now that the elimination, the way we vote is because of the competition. Like Rich getting fish for the group. That's not coming into foreplay yet because we're not starving to death yet. Maybe by day 20. We'll be like, yeah, he can catch fish. He's staying around, you know, but...
All right, it's raining too hard. Stacy. Well, the weather has spoken, and the tribe has spoken.
Okay. Oh, that's those big nuts. Sean's telling me looking for nuts is a waste of time. But at least you know you can find a nut. Sean sits there for 5 hours and builds his bowling alley to... Could have been all getting nuts or looking for tapioca during the day. I'm tired of feeding people that don't do anything. If we lose tomorrow, I'm voting Sean off.
The whole idea of an alliance is to make sure we're all voting the same way. So are we gonna stick to it?
I'm gonna stick to it. We have alliances that are happening within the group, and you're gonna have that. Just because, you know, everybody's, hey, there's money involved. 3 of us against the world.
We gotta stop them so bad.
Irritated with them, Sean and Dirk, going out wasting 3 days in the daylight fishing, and I let them know too. During the day, you should go out in the woods looking for tapioca and not to fish at night. You guys wasted 3 days fishing during the day.
I don't think it was a waste.
Well, did you catch anything?
No, ma'am.
Okay. It was a waste of time then.
I always wanted to kill a pig with a javelin with a spear.
And I was kind of hoping that I'd be good at nothing so that I could just like hang back and let the pressure go on somebody else. Turns out I throw the javelin the best. I'm thinking the other team's gonna have a guy throwing the spear. So if there is, it's a good chance that I can dog some guy on national TV. Cool.
No matter who they put up, you got it.
Even if we lost and I at least dogged the guy on the spear throwing, they'd be happy. As far as losing the challenge today, I was a little irritated. Here's my dream come true. I can stomp a guy on national television, and I missed by 2 inches. It was a bummer. But then when they pulled the chickens out, I started laughing. Cutting off a chicken's head, no, it's not what I would want to do for food. I can live without the chicken right now. They've kind of come around the last couple, 2-3 days. They started doing a little more, but it's a little too late for that.
Kelly, Sue, and I, we need to decide cohesively who we're going to eject. And it's between Sean and Dirk. And Sean, yesterday, he was talking about how he doesn't want to form an alliance because, you know, he do unto others. And what?
As others do unto you. It's just a game. This is not real life.
So we're thinking, boy, Sean, it's time for you to go, bud.
Travis spoke.
They better send them with some supplies. That's all I can say. There's 3 of them then we need out of here.
Greg
definitely. He's just way too psychotic. The other one is Speedball, Jenna.
She can get old pretty quickly.
She's gonna grow old real fast on us. Jarvis, he's a pervert. He's gone. And the chickens all better be dead because they're gonna be dead when they get here. As far as somebody coming here from Pagong today, it's gonna be fun. We like having company over at camp. Even though we don't have a whole lot to offer them for lunch, I'm hoping, I think the kicker of it all will be if Rich gets fish and we have fish for lunch, I think they'll be here. And the alliance that we have going on is Rich, Rudy, Kelly, and me. We'll vote 4 people strong. And if we can make it through the first 2 votes, getting somebody off of their team off, we should be able to slide in the home plate.
Yeah.
The reason Sean's not in the alliance because Sean is dumb. We're not sure of yet because Sean has been gone almost 24 hours now since we sent him off on the messenger thing. So the anticipation of waiting for Sean is just actually starting to drive us wild. Yeah, it's the same as it is back home, ladies, here in the jungle. The women are doing all the work and the guys are just hanging out and BSing, yeah.
Lewis, close, very close.
Gretchen, I need you to bring me your torch. Travis spoken.
Yeah, the women seem to be getting along well because the women are all workers. Actually, I like Jenna better than I thought I would. I thought she would drive me wild, and she doesn't, so.
Don't worry, the guys' days are numbered.
They
are numbered. Us girls are here for a while, trust me.
Oh man, I love
we'll be up at the end.
As far as the women becoming an alliance, there's a chance that the girls might want to have an alliance after there's a few more guys knocked off. If they do, I'll just lead on with them like, yeah, that's a good idea. But as far as the women forming an alliance and making one, no, it ain't going to happen. I already got mine. I like mine. I wish some of the other people would start conserving a little more, people that are being pigs. And I've cut myself, I only eat one bowl at a sitting. I'm planning on staying to the end, so I really want to have something for the last couple days.
I'm doing this off the top of my head, so I'm doing
this too.
You are me.
My dog.
I am you, and you are me. Together we make it through eternity. Not bad, eh? You know, here's Stinky. He's gonna come up and give you a big kiss. Here he comes.
Oh, you want a big kiss? Oh my God. Oh, my
dog looks so depressed.
The fact you have more people here now and we're having to forage for more food and there's a lot more slackers on this other team.
I'm nervous.
Nice guy. Oh. I don't like feeding people like that, though, you know what I mean? That's where I'm coming from now. Watch me. I'm gonna work that boy till he's gone now. Bugs me. Jerva's not that charming. Trust me. He's a slacker, so he won't be around long.
Oh, horrible.
What's happening now?
Nice work, man.
Wow, yes, Kitty Boy.
Congratulations.
Kitty Boy.
Very good.
Yank it down.
Very good, yes.
Well earned.
Yes. So as long as everybody can keep their mouth shut now, Kelly's a little freaky. She gets a little going. I'm like, just shut up. Just vote this and shut up. As far as there being a counter strategy from the other side, yeah, there is some fear about that because we haven't got enough of them voted off yet.
Susan. Straight up, is there an alliance?
No. Not that I vote people off that I don't care for. You know, that really would irritate me if I was working with them at a job or something like that. I got a chance to vote them off. I can get rid of them. So it's like, yeah!
Greg.
No!
Greg, the tribe has spoken.
Do you think I'm gonna come out and say, oh yeah, we got four of us voting up against all you guys, and we're gonna knock you all down to the end? Come on! When Rich came in with the fish, I said to Rudy, I said, I should go up there and stoke that fire up. And Rudy's like, oh no, 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 that's good enough. It's hot enough. And it wasn't hot enough. So the fish is tough to cook because they cooked a little bit and then they cooled off and they had to start the fire back up. And cook the fish again, so Rich is sort of irritated. We caught a fish today, finally. Yes. Yeah, it feels so good. Feels so accomplished now. He's gonna make a big point. Oh, that ain't a lot to feed you, but it's a point of it. We did catch it. So I don't give a f- how he's gonna say it. I don't care. We caught it. I feel accomplished. I did it. We've done it all now. I think it might bother him. In a way, I hope it does. I hope it bugs him. Now he can't say that no more. You know? This girl is caught this one.
Flip that over, Jarvis.
Good job, Rudy.
There you go.
Good job, Rudy.
Hang tight, buddy. We're going to be taking that talisman in a minute. Rudy, you win.
They were doing really, when they first got here, they're really ambitious. Now you can see their ambitions kind of like filtering a little bit. You're young, you hung out with the chicks. There's more Pagan members than Tagi members, and the Pagan members
the
sure
they have, don't like any of us.
They like you a lot better than any of us.
Sue, what's your take on that as somebody who might come up soon in the alphabet and get a vote against you, even if Sean thinks you're the greatest person here?
Sean just, he's neurotic. He's just an idiot.
Thanks a lot.
You
know,
so it's like, wow. Okay, so I'm next, you know. That's the way he votes, that's the way he votes. I just think he just, I don't know, that or he doesn't have enough balls to make a decision.
I don't have a malicious bone in my body. And I think casting a vote makes me feel malicious. If I want to avoid it, I want to avoid it.
But you came into this knowing you were going to have to do this. Me, I've changed my vote like 3 times within the last 2 hours.
And now
so.
It's me, right?
No. No.
The last vote. Jay or Jenna? Jenna, the tribe has spoken.
The sun is out. It's going to be a nice hot day. And it's quieter. Sorry, Jenna, but man, you talk a lot.
I don't blame them one bit for not worrying about fishing until there's five people.
That's a lot of mouths.
You know, and they don't appreciate it.
My strategy all along has been to just play the role as a dumb redneck.
There you go, Susie Q.
People, like, think rednecks are so vulnerable and dumb that they'll talk to them openly, like Rich did. You know how he's going to burn everybody.
Okay, so here's the deal. I want you to pick her to be ejected, not me, so you can plan that.
Hopefully, in the end, the old redneck will burn the city slicker, so we'll see what happens. I've been knowing all along that I'm going to burn him, but I didn't want to say anything to Kelly too early.
Why do you think he got so many votes against him at the last council?
He's a snake. I got to thank him, though, for getting our crap together early. If it wasn't for him, we might not have gotten together this early. I never trusted Rich. Of course I don't trust him, but am I doing a good job making him think I trust him? I hope it looks like I trust him now.
I knew he was working on you to get me out anyway.
Oh, yeah.
He's not that smart.
Right now, I don't trust anybody except for Kelly. I trust Kelly 100%. 100%. She trusts me the same. We're like sisters. And it'll be 20 years come this Easter that I lost my best friend. So coming across Kelly, somebody I can hang with, that's so long. I ain't gonna fuck her. I'm not burning her.
We seriously lucked out. I have no idea what I would have done had I ended up on Pagong in the beginning.
Oh, me too.
Committed suicide.
I'd have killed somebody.
But I could never have built alliances. I mean, such solid ones particularly, too.
They're too flaky. Too immature.
Changes with the wind.
Too immature, yeah. Is what it is. Like, Kelly's even a little flaky at moments.
She's doing well, though. I mean, 22, yeah. She's amazing.
Oh, yeah. We're all sitting here. We're adults. This is a game, but the game also reflects a lot on real life. And you always bring up this alliance thing. Well, America is run on alliance. The minute somebody gives money to the president for his campaign as a lobbyist, that's an alliance. Don't tell me he doesn't think he doesn't owe them anything, because he does. They help put him where he's at. Same thing goes when people join a church and they're not religious, but they join the church because they want to make connections for, be it their insurance agent, and they want to sell more insurance in town, or their real estate agent, and they want to sell real estate, so they want to meet up with people. So there is going to be an alliance. Don't tell me they're in an alliance. Well, Taggy, we lived together for 20 days, built a house, built a camp, comfortable, totally happy with each other. Like, we ain't going to have some kind of bonding there. Yeah, there's going to be alliances. This is just a chess game. This is the way life goes.
How you spell it? Anyways, you're a nice guy. I wish you best of luck. But I'm tired of getting beat at the competitions by you guys, so.
Jervis, tribe has spoken.
Kelly's staying in the alliance at this time, but she's trying to make herself look good to the other team in case it comes down to the end and she's going to be one of the last two standing, that she will be like, oh, I didn't align with them. And we're like, this time, no, baby doll, you're not going to look good. As far as the rain, well, I think it was a big deterior on a lot of people. Really kind of ate at them. Oh, my God, I don't know if I want to live with some of them right now. Right beyond retired, hungry, cold.
Put it this way, it beats driving a semi through Chicago at 4 o'clock on a Friday summer afternoon.
Sean finally leaves to go off to his yacht excursion, and then he hollers out, hey, I can invite somebody for breakfast.
I can invite someone for breakfast. Who wants it?
Take her.
Kelly, do you want that to be a meal?
Sean, it's your decision. Don't pound it off on me.
Yeah, Sean, get some balls and make a decision.
Hatchy, scrambled eggs.
We'll see you in the morning, Hatch.
Sean makes up his mind and he invites Rich.
The guy's dumb. He's so dumb. Is he not?
6 more days of rice. I might even skip the last day of eating altogether. Just not to eat rice.
Actually, for him to come and visit the camp was sort of cool, but he didn't know anything.
So that war over in Russia sort of mellowed out.
What?
They had the one there again towards the end.
I don't know.
We're like, what's going on in the world? He didn't know none of that. Really?
What about the college playoffs? Who won?
Wait a minute.
Duke?
No.
Vienna?
No. Who the hell won? See, I'm not really a sportsman.
Oh, he's just like Sean. He's just lovable, but doof. Then right when he goes to leave this afternoon, about an hour and a half, hour ago, he has this gray bag, and in it there's a care package for each one of us.
Rich.
So in it we each got a little something from one of our loved ones from back home.
Okay, Sue, so if Kelly wins immunity, what happens? Sean or Colleen?
I'm thinking Sean.
Are you thinking Sean or Colleen?
What are you thinking?
I'll go with what you guys say.
What
do you
say, Sean?
I'm feeling, you know, Sean, but we've been all Sean-ing, you know.
Take the
wisdom
of the old man.
Okay. Rudy says, Sean, so if Kelly hangs in there, Sean is over here tonight. So we gotta watch, because it's down to the wire.
Kelly, you got immunity.
Me and Kelly, I thought I had a real friendship going. I really did. But when I turn around and see somebody starting to dig a knife into my backside, it just really pisses me off.
Colleen, you need to bring me your torch.
Nice to each other.
You told him you weren't aligned with us, because Colleen told me that.
That's bull.
Well, I don't give a because I trust her more than I trust you.
Why? That's bull. I've been your friend since day one.
No, I'm going fishing.
That's bull. Will you talk to me?
No. I don't have to. Kelly made all the rest of us look like a bunch of idiots. Then she made all the rest of us look like the bad guys and her the one good guy out of the whole 5 of us. That's what irritated me. This is my second gray sting since I've been here. Oh, and trust me, they hurt. It's like an aching sting and it hurts from my knuckle down about here. And it's constantly pounding and it aches and it hurts really bad. I might act like a tough girl, but they do hurt. They gouged me. Yeah, this one got me good.
I'm just looking forward to talking to my husband on the phone. I can't wait for that. I get anywhere within a phone to make a call. That's what I'm doing. It's calling home.
Uh-huh.
I don't give what time of day it is there.
Yeah, the mud game was a blast. I had a blast. Fun. Total, a lot of fun. Doing the mud thing really wore a lot of energy out of us, so it did key us down quite a bit. And Kelly's the only other girl on the island with me, so we're gonna hang together to the end.
But
whatever, yeah.
You know.
But no, I ain't gonna let you into the tree if I can possibly help it, because you're a threat to me in the end. We came to an agreement that we treat each other civil till the time we leave here. No sense to make it hard on anybody.
Yeah, but we're here possibly together for the next 4 days, so
yeah.
Let's just be civil.
I know. That's why I thought we were being very civil.
No, I thought we were too. I just wanted to clear that up.
Yeah, I have won no challenges, no rewards. And you know what? I'm not even thinking I'm gonna win anymore. But I wanna win the last one. I'm like, oh man, if I win any, I'm praying that I win the very last immunity. If I'm here, if I make it through the next 4, which I think I will.
I guess you get to keep this.
There you go.
Good job, Kai.
Nice job, Wiggles, all right.
Last question, Sue. One point you said early on, I think in fact it might have been to Rich, I'm not sure. One of the first few days here, you said, listen, I'm just a redneck and corporate America isn't gonna play here.
Oh, she sure did.
But just a couple of tribal councils ago, you made a pretty good case for the fact that what goes on here at Survivor is really no different than what goes on in corporate America. So my question is, what has won out? Simple Midwestern values or the harsh reality of corporate life?
It ain't over with yet, so you can't say who's won out yet, eh? The idea of money makes the world go round. Money's
greed, money is what everybody thrives for. I don't care what anybody says anymore. It's what spins us. It can make life a little bit easier if you're you know, struggling or whatever. It helps. Big fights, divorces happen over shortages of money. So, a lot to be said about money, Jeff. That's what we're talking about.
It was fun. Good luck, buddy.
John, you need to bring me your torch. The tribe has spoken. The jungle has spoken. It's time for you to go.
We're down to 60 hours. So 60 hours, if you look at it that way, I can deal with it. For a chance to win $1 million. But the hardest thing for me here now has come down to probably the boredom. What's it like living with somebody you don't care for at the time, sleeping next to your enemy? You just do it. You just hang out with them and eat next to them and just treat them like a civil person. That's all you can do. After Gretchen, she didn't vote in any of the way the Lions voted. She's setting herself up so that if she is the last two at the end, she's gonna make herself look really good. Because we knew there'd be more Pagan on the jury than Taggy. Guys, what it is greedy. She thinks she got like 5-6 people ago. It was like, you could see her turn a little bit. Then I was really irritated. This has not been easy to, you know, come out here in the island and get bit up by bugs and stung by stingrays. So I told Kelly, my family's my number one goal. I think I got a better chance of winning $1 million with Arrogant Rich by my side than with her at my side. Well, it's cutthroat time. I would say that Rich, Rudy, and I are getting along well. And Kelly's the one we've been wanting to get out of here. We're praying that one of us three wins today so we can boot her out.
Let's reveal. This is for immunity. Sue? You don't know? Kelly, Christopher is right. Kelly, well done. Immunity.
Rich.
Our first tie. Sue?
Okay. Rudy? I'm not gonna say anything. I'm just leaving it the way it is. You know me. You know how I operate, whatever. Whatever you wanna do.
Sue.
Thanks, sweetie.
Okay. I'm ready to go.
Need to bring me your torch.
You?
Have a smoke and coffee.
Okay. Okay.
The tribe has spoken.
Okay. I'll see you guys later. Oh, I appreciate being able to talk to everybody for the last time. I said, it'd be great if I could finish in the top 4 or 5. I finished top 4. Hey, that's good enough for me. You know, outside of the weather and being cold and rainy when it rained at night and the sand fleas, this was a lot easier for me than drive a truck through Chicago every day of the week. That's a lot worse than being out here in the bush. You will not get my vote. My vote will go to Richard. And I hope that is the one vote that makes you lose the money. If it's not, so be it. I'll shake your hand. And I'll go on from here. But if I were ever pass you along in life again, and you were laying there dying of thirst, I would not give you a drink of water. I would let the vultures take you and do whatever they want with you, with no ill regrets. I plead to the jury tonight, this island is pretty much full of only two things, snakes and rats. And in the end of Mother Nature, we have Richard the snake, who knowingly went after prey, and Kelly, who turned into the rat that ran around like the rats do on this island, trying to run from the snake. I feel we owe it to the island's spirits that we have learned to come to know, to let it be in the end the way Mother Nature intended it to be, for the snake to eat the rat.